What is going on, guys? Jace2Cents here, and I've been hounded on Twitter, on Tech Talk, and all of my videos, especially about Skunkworks, on my opinions about 4K panels. And guess what? That's what we're gonna talk about today, so you don't wanna miss this. Now I've got to go ahead and give a huge shout out to my friends over at MassDrop. They have sponsored today's video by sending me this 4K monitor. There's a reason for that, so make sure you guys stay till the end of the video. Now real quick, if you guys don't know what MassDrop is, basically they broker some huge group rate discounts on various products. I mean, shoot, they even have like scrapbooking stuff up there. I mean, like scrapbooking. Now when it comes to the specs of this MonoPrice monitor, it is a TN panel, so that might leave a bad taste in some people's mouths, but go ahead and give it a chance and watch to the end of this video. You might be pleasantly surprised. Now TN panels are great for high refresh rates, high response times, and very good for gamers and fast moving content for the most part. But if you're a content creator creating videos or photography, you know, TN panels tend to leave a little bit lacking when it comes to the color recreation and color accuracy. But I do think that this is doing a pretty good job, and we'll talk a little bit more about that in the future. Now it does have a 1,000:1 contrast ratio. Now don't let that fool you. 1,000:1 is actually pretty good. A lot of manufacturers will put something stupid like 1,000,000:1 because of some perfect circumstances that could create what would be considered a 1,000,000:1 contrast ratio. But 1,000:1 in a fully lit room like this is actually pretty damn good. Now it is a 28-inch 16x9 diagonal measured monitor. It does have its own base, you know, that swivels a lot like the Asus monitors. It does actually rotate, so you can rotate this thing, if you do it the right way, to a portrait style monitor if you wanna do that. I know a lot of content creators and web developers like portrait because you can see longer lines of code. And it actually has a whole bunch of inputs. In fact, this monitor has two HDMI MHL ports, two DisplayPort 1.2 ports, a DVI, a dual link DVI, as well as 2-watt speakers in this. So you could essentially hook this up to, you know, something that you needed sound for. I wouldn't recommend it, but you could. The one thing I think is lacking though is it does have no built-in cable management. At least the Asus panels have cutouts right here so that you can run cables through the stand so they're not kind of walking around everywhere. But if you're like me, and chances are you would put this on some sort of a monitor arm, it does have a 100x100 standard VESA mount. So you could put this on a monitor arm and have it swiveling and doing all kinds of crazy stuff on your desk if you wanted. Now the power brick on this is external from the panel. So that means that it's gonna keep the panel fairly thin. It does adjust up and down, as you can see. In terms of aesthetics, it's actually a very, very attractive monitor. It's got a black brushed aluminum bezel on the bottom. It's got a 5/8-inch bezel around it, which, you know, if you're gonna put multiples of these side by side, they wouldn't exactly be low profile bezels. So you would have a fairly decent gap, pretty close to 1.5-inch gap on there. But for the most part, I think for a single panel on a desk, this thing is fantastic. Now, of course, it's 4K. So in order to run 4K games, you're gonna have to really have some horsepower. Now I wanna talk real quick about cable options for this, because I learned very quickly, 4K is very picky when it comes to cables. Now I actually started this video last night and I scrapped the video because a lot of 4K panels, you can actually run two HDMI 1.4 and get 30 hertz per HDMI. It basically splits the screen in two, stitches it together, and gives you two panels, kind of like an NV Surround or an iFinity, giving you a total of 60 hertz, but that wasn't working. In fact, this monitor does not support that. I think the Asus does, but this one does not. So DisplayPort 1.2 is really your only option of getting 60 hertz or 60 frames per second. All other options, HDMI 1.4, even HDMI 2.0, which is 18 gigabit per second cable and can carry a 60 hertz signal, does not translate into 60 hertz or 60 frames per second on this panel. So I wasted a lot of time yesterday trying to get this thing to do 60 hertz without a DisplayPort 1.2. Not gonna happen, folks. So anyway, you live and learn. One thing I do not like about this monitor though is, as you can see, the glossy finish. See that? See the reflection there? I do think that matte panels look a lot better when it comes to games and just content and looking at your screen, because you're not getting your reflection bounced back at you. I don't know about you guys, I don't like looking at myself in my monitor. The last thing I want to see when I'm playing my games is the gamer faces I make. They're not pretty. I would like to see some sort of a matte option on this, but there is a positive. Glossy screens tend to make the color pop more. They tend to make the blacks a little deeper, and they are a lot easier to clean in most cases, but you're gonna have to be very mindful of what you use to clean it, because if you use anything that's even slightly abrasive, you're gonna eventually turn this into a matte finish, if you know what I mean. All right, well, let's go ahead and talk about gaming performance on this thing. I did find the refresh rate to be 60 hertz. It was very input lag free. I didn't have any problems playing on it. The 5 millisecond response time seemed like 5 milliseconds. I didn't notice any perceived input lag whatsoever. But as always, with the amount of pixels that this thing has, which is essentially 4 times the number of pixels that 1080p has, you've got to have some serious horsepower to push it. Now, fortunately, Skunkworks is able to do it. And I'm not going to give you those numbers because I think I'm going to do a separate video about Skunkworks versus 4K. But I will tell you that it was extremely smooth. There was no tearing. There was no ghosting. It was actually a very pleasant gaming experience. But one thing you got to keep in mind also is that the text is going to be very, very small. 28-inch monitor is pretty good size for 1080p or 1440. 4K, man, you practically need magnifying glass or like a jeweler's eye to look at the text on this thing. Now, if you're running Windows 7, it's even worse. At least Windows 8.1 will automatically scale the UI to give you a usable, readable text size. Windows 7, on the other hand, I'm not kidding, it is the smallest text I've ever seen. In fact, it was making my eyes more bloodshot than they already are. But yeah. Anyway, guys, I do think the MonoPrice monitor comes in at a price point that makes sense. I mean, this thing comes in at about $500. 4K panels have really come down, and a 60 hertz panel, $500, I can look past the fact that it's TN. Now, it's not all fun and games. In fact, sometimes input switching seems to be a problem. You know, some games, when it switches between full screen and windowed mode, like, you know, desktop, going back and forth, the screen will turn off for a second and then it has to come back on. Sometimes this didn't come back on. And I don't know if that's the graphics card, the driver, or the cable's fault, but sometimes I was left with sound and the computer doing its thing and hearing the hard drive click away or watching the hard drive light go, but have no picture. And the only way to make the picture come back is to turn off the monitor or turn it back on, or sometimes even worse, do a reboot on the system. Now, I don't know exactly what's causing that problem. It could be the OS, it could be the monitor. I really don't know. So I'm gonna play with it some more and see how that ends up working out. But enough about that. I think it's a great monitor at $500 range. It just makes sense. I mean, remember when 4K's first launched, they were like $2,000, $3,000, something stupid like that. It's actually becoming very affordable if you have the graphics horsepower to push it. Otherwise, don't even consider trying to play games. Now, I did run this at the HDMI 30 hertz. Forget it. That was nasty. It was terrible. In fact, the screen was so laggy, it gave me perceived input lag because even the mouse moving around was jumping everywhere. 30 hertz, maybe you're in the console and maybe that's okay with you. 30 hertz on a PC is absolutely unacceptable. I don't even know why it has those other ports on there, to be honest with you. Now, one thing that kind of makes me upset, though, is MonoPrice does not include a DisplayPort cable in the box. Considering you cannot get 4K 60 hertz, which is the selling point of this monitor, without a DisplayPort 1.2 cable, give me a freaking cable in the box, MonoPrice. It doesn't make any sense not to do that. Now, I do hear that they're going to start putting them in the box. How many of these units have already been shipped to retailers without it? Then you're gonna be left driving all around town trying to find one. And do you know what kind of looks people give you when you ask for a DisplayPort 1.2 cable? Most people don't even know what you're talking about. The guys over at Best Buy had their thumb up their butt. They tried to sell me a $100 HDMI cable. Yeah, he didn't like it when I told him how full of shit he was. But anyway, I headed over to Office Depot thinking maybe they would have something there. And the salesman there tried to tell me that DisplayPort 1.2 was only available through Dell. Scary, folks. So if you actually put a DVI or a DisplayPort 1.2 cable in the box, MonoPrice, from the start, this would have gotten all the rave from me. But you didn't. You gave a DVI cable, which is not even capable of giving the selling point of the monitor, and that's an atrocity. Especially when you're MonoPrice. You guys are like the cable kings of the world, and you didn't give one. Anyway, I'm done with that rant. Let's go ahead and talk about the surprise at the end of this video. MassDrop wants you guys to have one of these. All you guys have to do is go into the description, open it up, there's a link there. I don't get any kickback, I don't get any money. All you gotta do is click on that, sign up for MassDrop. It's entirely free, there's no charge. You guys can check out some of the other offers they have. By doing that, that automatically enters you into a worldwide giveaway where you can win one of these monitors on your own. There's no entry, there's no fee, there's no push to subscribe, no like, no follow on Twitter, none of that crap. Just click the link, sign up for Mass Drop, which is free. Take a look at what kind of Mass Drops they're doing, and one of these could be your own. If you don't want to enter your email and make a password for a chance at a free 4K monitor, well then that increases the chances for everyone else. So guys, I'm gonna get the heck on out of here. It's been Jay's Two Cents taking a look at the MonoPrice 28-inch Ultra HD 4K monitor. I think it's pretty damn nice when it's coupled with the correct cable. Get on that MonoPrice, and you guys get on that giveaway, like right now. If you don't, hell, I'm gonna enter it. I could use two of these things. See you in the next one, guys.